This bushy plant is called Peperomia metallica, or metallic peperomia for obvious reasons. It has this beautiful, almost chocolate green metallic sheen. And if you just turn the leaf over, you'll see it has this nice burgundy red wine colored hue on the bottom. This coloration immediately tells me that this is probably an understory species. And I actually go more into this coloration into the Houseplant Masterclass if you're curious about that. It's actually one of my favorite sections of the course. But for all intents and purposes, this is a plant that doesn't grow with a tremendous amount of light, which is the case for a lot of Peperomia species. This one in particular is much bushier than a lot of my other Peperomia. I've had this for going on almost 4 years now, and it grows in my swing garden, my vertical swing garden in my kitchen, pulled away from a northeast-facing window, probably about a foot to a foot and a half. And you can see that it's kind of putting out these new little stems here and new growth, which is actually just really beautiful. There are so many different variations of Peperomia metallica. This is native a little bit more to Colombia and to Ecuador and some parts of South America. And I think they found many different variations of different species. And I have seen Peperomia metallica that is not so meaty. It's actually like better in a terrarium. But for whatever reason, this variation is a little bit more of a succulent stem, a little bit more of a harder stem, and much more like thicker leaves, which I think is good because I don't actually have this in terrarium conditions. Of course, if you're giving it a little bit more humidity, it would probably like that, but I'm just growing it in my kitchen, which has a little bit more to low to moderate humidity. But if you have one of those ones that seem a little bit daintier, I would definitely kind of put it in a little bit more of a terrarium condition. As far as soil goes, I have this in a fairly well-draining mix. Again, like most Peperomia that have the semi-succulent nature, they don't like to be sitting in a wet diaper. They don't like to be sitting in like wet soil, for instance. So you want something that's a little bit more well-draining, that if you actually do give it water, it kind of just sits on the roots just for a little bit and then kind of drains through. Propagation, these plants are relatively easy, and I have a whole propagation section on Peperomia in many of my different videos, which you can refer to on YouTube, but actually taking a little leaf cutting with a bit of the petiole, which is the stem that attaches to the stem and the leaf blade, is going to be very easy to actually then propagate more of this plant. And as far as resiliency to pests, I have to say I haven't had any problems with Peperomia metallica whatsoever. It's a super easy plant to grow. And if you're going to be fertilizing it, then I would say a general well-balanced fertilizer, make a 10-10-10, for instance, if you're doing synthetic, cut by half, or a gentler organic fertilizer on a bi-weekly basis is going to be perfect for this particular plant.